so clear. I'm finding I can't do this on my own. And I don't know where to go from here. As long as I know that you are near, I'm done fighting, I'm finally letting go. I will trust in you. You've never failed before. I will trust in you. If there's a road I should walk, help me find it. If I need to be still, give me peace for the moment. Whatever your will, whatever your will, can you help me find it? Can you help me find it? Giving you fear and you give faith. Giving you doubt, you give me grace. For every step, I've never been alone. Even when it hurts, you'll have your way. Even in the valley, I will say, with every breath, you've never let me go. I will wait for you. You've never failed before. Road I should walk, help me find it. If I need to be still, give me peace for the moment. Whatever your will, can you help me find it? Can you help me find it? I lift my empty
request this morning. As you prepare for communion, I want you to be mindful. What is that one thing that is pretty clear that you need to let go of? What's that thing that you are gripping pretty tight to? And yet you know that to take the next step into faithfulness, it's really something you need to set down. Bring that to your heart, to your mind. And as we come forward for communion, think about how you're not only just setting it down, but the love of God that meets you at this table will help you relinquish it. And the good news is that any time a people find themselves with open hands, they don't remain open and empty for very long. God places something there. Today it will be the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the gifts of God that stay with us forever. Let us prepare for time at the table.
Jesus sits at the table, breaking the bread with his friends. What he is able.
This morning, let's pause. Just pause for a moment. Pause and think about mending your nets. What do you need to relinquish or let go of? Remember God's mercy and Jesus' call to follow Him. Think about letting go of any of burdens or obstacles that are holding you back from being Christ's disciples. And bring those when you come to the table and leave them here. Leave them behind and leave with Christ's mercy and grace. Your burdens will be lifted, your sins forgiven, and you are new again in Christ. All are welcome to come forward to this table. It's the Lord's table. It's not Cypress Creek's table. It's God's table. And if you cannot come forward, raise your hand and we will be happy to serve you right where you are. And as you come, bring your tithes and offerings and your blue cards and place them in the baskets up front. Let us pray.
Father of all creation, we are your humble servants. May we become more like the disciples by letting go of some of our ways so we can use the skills you have bestowed upon us. Please help us redirect them in a more useful way to better serve you and your people. Lord, we come to this table in need of your nourishment. May you bless these elements here before us so we can become closer to you. As disciples, we were taught the prayer our Father gave us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen.
On the night he was betrayed, Jesus was gathered in an upper room with his friends, his disciples. They didn't understand what was about to happen, so Jesus showed them. He took an ordinary loaf of bread, and he broke it, and he blessed it, and he gave it to them, saying, This is my body broken for you. Eat this in remembrance of me. In a like manner, he took an ordinary cup of wine, and he blessed it. And he said, This is the covenant of my blood shed for you and the many for forgiveness of sins. Drink this in remembrance of me. And every time you gather in my name, do this in remembrance of me. So we take the bread and the juice, and we take a piece of bread and dip it in the cup and partake of the elements.
When the valley is deep, when the mountain is steep, when the body is weary, stumble and fall.
When the choices are hard, when we're battered and scarred, when we've spent our resources, when we're giving our all, in Jesus' name we press on.
Love that song. You know, as I share in this sermon, I've been trying to help us let go of little things as a community over the last year or so. Just little things along the way. But as I have been doing that among us, I've also been trying to do a little bit of that within myself. And let's just be honest, it can sometimes be very tough. And it's funny how we think, oh, actually, that's easy to set down. We let go of it. And then a week later, we look down and it's back there. How did that get back there? I mean, it's just habit. There are things that we, for comfort, for a sense of security, we want to be holding on to. Sometimes it's physical, sometimes it's emotional, sometimes it's spiritual. And yet, to move into that future that God is casting for us, there are things that we need to relinquish. And my hope and prayer is that we have started some new work on that together as a community of faith. Yes, it's something we need to do as individuals, but it is easier done in the context of community. Here at Cypress Creek Christian Church, every Sunday, there is an invitation extended on behalf of the living Christ. An invitation not only to connect one's life with a covenant community, but to connect one's life with Christ. If you wish to respond to that invitation, you can do so in a couple ways. You can come forward as we are singing our song of discipleship, or you can meet with one of our elders or pastoral staff immediately after the service. I invite you now, if you're able, to please stand and let all of us join our voices.
Drawing close, your light is shining.
some fun, exciting stuff happening in the life of our congregation that I want to share with you. First of all, Wednesday studies continue this week. During the noon hour, I'm teaching one on the Trinity. If you missed the first week, that's okay. Come and join us for that. We usually gather around 11:30, bring a sack lunch, and just share in conversation. Wednesday night at 6:30, Dr. Mark Whitten, member of our congregation, is going to be continuing his study on looking at other faith traditions, including Islam. It was a fascinating study last week, but each week is self-contained, so if you missed last week, we invite you to come this week. Prison ministry training. We have a marvelous prison ministry out of this congregation, but for anyone who wants to do that kind of work in our prisons or jails here in the state of Texas has to go through a training. Well, we're hosting one this Saturday here at Cypress Creek, and if you've even been thinking about it, attending does not mean you're signing on the bottom line, but you have to go through this training. So the registration's at 8, it's from 9 to 1 o'clock this Saturday. And we would invite you, if you're thinking about coming, give the church a call, because we need to know how many handouts to have, those kinds of things. So I think we're almost to 40 now, both within our church and some groups outside our church. So we'd love to have you be a part of that, and maybe someday down the road help participate in our marvelous ministry to those who are imprisoned. Next Sunday, two important things. During the services, we are going to be doing a blessing of our elders and board members for the new 2015 year. So come and be a part of that. And like I said in the sermon, it's going to be a Sunday for doing a little vision casting. So I hope you'll be a part of what I think will be kind of a conversation that we are going to be having. I want to invite you to stop by the Fair Trade table out there. Some wonderful good stuff that goes to support marvelous people around the globe. And two other things. In your program, there is information about our mentoring program for young people who are considering baptism. Make note of that. And reminding people about also Wednesday nights, the dance classes that are happening if you are interested in that. And finally, this Tuesday is a men's ministry program. And I'm going to have you watch just a little video clip.
Courage is doing the right thing in every circumstance, regardless of the cost. That's what courage is.
We make courage about the brave heart. You know, we make courage about an oncoming cavalry and standing your ground. And most of us aren't going to do that. Most of us aren't going to stare death in the face and smile at it. All right, that's not what most of us are going
to
do.
Courage is a radical obedience in the face of what scares you to death. It is not pulling back, it's pressing into your fears. It's not denying your fears, but it's seeing what needs to be advanced, what needs to be accomplished as greater than your personal comfort.
Being courageous doesn't mean that you're not afraid. In fact, it's the opposite. It's when you're afraid that courage is counted on the most and needed the most. Yeah.
Again, this Tuesday, it says 7:30. That's when the study begins. Dinner starts at 7, so take note of that. And we're meeting at Kramer Retreat Center, but if you don't know where that is, I'm going to be up here at 6:30 p.m., and we can carpool, we can drive together, whatever you can follow to make sure you can get there. I think it'll be the beginning of a wonderful study for some of the men in our church, so please take note of that. Now, if you would, please grab the hand of somebody close. God, I give you thanks for the people that have chosen to gather here this day, for your invitation for us to participate in this time of worship. But we know that once again you will be setting before us different invitations, different requests, and some of them will be tough. Some will require for us to set down a few things, and we pray, oh God, that you will help us, that you will assist us through your grace, so that we might fully follow you as disciples of the Christ. We pray this in his most holy name. Amen.